GPT-3 is the most modern third-generation language model developed by OpenAI. The model, which is a language predictive, basically analyzes when you give the head of the sentence and predicts which word will come, or the commands you give to the model come to life. GPT-3 can take a higher number of parameters than previous language models such as GPT-2 and therefore has higher accuracy. There is also fierce competition in artificial intelligence technology. In February 2020, Microsoft introduced the Turing Natural Language Generation (TNLG). This model was the world's largest language model with 17 billion parameters on the day it was published. This model performed better than any other language model in various tasks such as summarizing texts and answering questions. However, OpenAI's third-generation language model was able to increase the number of parameters that this model has 10 times. The parameter capacity of the full version of GPT-3 is 175 billion. These parameters have been trained in hundreds of billions of words. The cost of this training to OpenAI was $12 million. Commands are made for GPT-3 as the most dangerous algorithm ever produced. Hello everyone from Trendyez Academy. In this video, I will talk about the new star of artificial intelligence, GPT-3. If you are new to our channel, before starting the lesson, be sure to subscribe and turn on notifications. Artificial intelligence is one of the hottest topics of our time, maybe the first. There seems to be no space left where artificial intelligence does not enter. Machine learning is a subfield of artificial intelligence. Improved algorithms, more powerful computers, and increase in digital data have increased the innovations in machine learning, according to The Economist. Models are now trained by learning from thousands or even billions of samples. Assistants controlling our health with machine learning, driverless cars, suggestion systems that give advice according to our taste, systems that recognize and take pictures have now entered our daily lives. These applications were developed with deep learning techniques, which are the subfields of machine learning. Deep learning has developed very rapidly in recent years with the increase of data produced today and the advancement of computer technology. One of the most popular areas of deep learning is natural language processing. It consists of multiple disciplines such as natural language processing, computer science, statistics, and linguistics. With natural language processing, tasks such as question and answer, extracting the main idea in the text, classifying documents, chatbot are performed. Various models for natural language processing have previously have been developed such as GPT, Turing, and NLG. OpenAI has developed the fastest and most modern language framework with open source code called GPT-3. GPT-3 stands for Generative Pre-trained Transformer 3. With the GPT-3, it can perform human-style tasks. GPT-3 is actually a more advanced version of GPT-2, which was released last year. While there were 110 million adjustable parameters in the algorithm, first published under the name of GPT, this number reached 1.5 billion in GPT-2. GPT-2 has a capacity of 1.5 billion parameters and the dataset it uses was 8 million web pages. The multiplicity of parameters make it easier for artificial intelligence to learn. In other words, the more parameter capacity a model has, the more accurate predictions it can make. You can see the parameter capacity of GPT-3 and other language models on the screen. GPT-3 has a capacity of 175 billion parameters. GPT-3's parameter capability differs from other models. The data used by GPT-3 is too much. Common Crawl, Wikipedia, web text, books, and some additional resources were used for the initial training of GPT-3. You know Wikipedia, the internet encyclopedia. Common Crawl, on the other hand, is a non-profit organization founded by Jill Elbaz that has been scanning and archiving information on the web since 2011. Common Crawl scans every month and contains petabytes of data. Here, GPT-3 was trained using these resources. OpenAI allows a limited number of people to access the GPT-3 API. OpenAI said that to discover the power of GPT-3, users can make requests to access GPT-3's API. We can understand that GPT-3 can do from the posts of people using GPT-3. So, what can be done with GPT-3? GPT-3 is able to produce text that is indistinguishable from what people have written. Write poetry, translate text, establish dialogue, write code, and even answer abstract questions. The text generation quality of GPT-3 is quite high. It is difficult to distinguish these produced texts from those written by a human. For example, the following sentence was produced by GPT-3. You can't get rid of doubt by replacing it with trust. It's hard to believe, but you can produce succinct lyrics that you can use on Twitter or Facebook with GPT-3. GPT-3 does it in encoding. You say what you want to do with this model. GPT-3 codes according to what you say. All you have to do is define your application. Users with access to GPT-3 share some examples. For example, GPT-3 has a button that says roll the dice on it and show its value. Artificial intelligence makes this simple application in a few seconds and shows you its code. You can make more detailed descriptions for GPT-3. The value of the dice is between 0 and 100 with a title above. Within a few seconds, you can use both HTML design and the necessary functions to generate JavaScript code. Do you want to make an application that reflects your mood? You describe your application in the describe section. For example, you want a headline and buttons with happy, sad and sleepy. You also want the buttons to write your mood on the screen. When you wrote these recipes, your application written with React is ready. You can now print your mood on the screen by pressing the buttons. Didn't you like what you wrote this? Want to show your emotions with emoji? Then you say express my emotions with emoji and your mood is now displayed with emojis. You can reflect your mood by pressing the buttons. If you want, you can produce any human face you want with the GPT-3. All you have to do is make the recipe. For example, you say produce a young looking black woman with brown eyes and long hair. In seconds, you come across human faces with the features you want. You say produce middle-aged white man with blue eyes and brown hair, whose left side is visible, and faces appear as you describe for seconds. Do you want to produce an Asian male with a natural expression with a visible right side? You enter the recipe and faces appear. You may want to produce a Latin woman with medium-length hair. Or you might want to produce a female face with green eyes and blonde hair. And you came across the faces we described. Finally, you asked for a happy boy face. And for seconds, a variety of happy faces came across. Isn't that great? Users who make some queries with the GPT-3 shared their experiences on social media. A user named Levasia on Twitter asked the computer, when will the coronavirus end? Via the GPT-3 algorithm directed the question. The answer of the program was December 31, 2023. Levasio, who asked a user who said, ask how it will end, received the answer, the coronavirus pandemic will end with the death of all infected individuals. GPT-3 model architecture is transformation-based neural networks. This architecture became popular 2-3 years ago. With this architecture, BERT and GPT-3 previous version GPT-2 models were developed. Language models such as BERT need careful fine-tuning. For example, in order to translate from one language to another using such models, it is necessary to teach the model how to translate. To use the BERT model for a specific task such as translation, summarizing, spam detection, it is necessary to use huge data sets. Finding these data sets is difficult or even impossible. With the GPT-3, tasks can be carried out without the need for fine-tuning. This is the most important feature of GPT-3. Well, we should be afraid of GPT-3 or we should be glad. Comments are made for GPT-3 as the most dangerous algorithm ever produced. New York Times columnist Farhad Manju, in his review, published in the newspaper's July 29, 2020 issue, commented on GPT-3. This artificial intelligence, which can produce computer code and poetry as well as prose, is not only surprising and spooky, but also terrifying, was found. The potential of GPT-3 to generate fake news on platforms like deepfake is shown as a reason to approach with fear in the tech world. It is very difficult to distinguish the articles produced by the GPT-3 from the text written by people. Therefore, it should be said that this model has its downsides, such as being able to write fake academic articles, disseminate false information, and abuse laws. These models are fed by data generated by humans. In fact, the more good and useful data human beings produce, the better these models will be. Therefore, to the questions that we should be afraid of artificial intelligence that people ask, the best answer will again be us humans. Thank you for watching our video. If you like our video, don't forget to press the like button, subscribe and share. See you in the next videos. Bye now.